Hi everyone. We know that all living beings need food. We have learned that green plants make their own food, whereas animals and human beings, they need to depend on plants and other animals to get their food. So based on their eating habits, animals are broadly classified into three groups. They are herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Let us see a few examples. Cows, goats, monkeys, deers, elephants, giraffes, all these are the examples of herbivores. First, let us learn the meaning of it. So it is a word derived from Latin, herba, which means a small plant, and vor or vorare means to eat. So herbivores are nothing but plant-eating animals. So herbivores are the plant-eating animals which get their energy by depending on plant food. They eat fruits, grass, and the leaves of the plant in order to get their energy. So this is the first group of animals which depend on plants in order to get their food. We call them herbivores. Cows, goats, monkeys, deers, elephants, giraffes, all these are the examples of herbivores. Coming to the second group, they are the carnivores. So this is also derived from Latin. Carne means meat or flesh. Vorare or vor is to eat. So all the flesh-eating animals are called as carnivores. Let us see a few examples. Lions, wolves, leopards, tigers, hyenas, and sharks, all these are the flesh-eating animals. They depend on other animals in order to get their food, whereas herbivorous animals, they eat plants and only plants, whereas carnivorous animals, they eat only the flesh of other animals. Carne means meat and vor means to eat. All the flesh-eating animals are called as carnivores. You know hyenas, eagle, vulture, they are also called as scavengers. You know the meaning of scavenger? They depend on the dead flesh. They consume the dead flesh and they play a major role in maintaining a healthy habitat. So scavengers are the animals where they eat, they depend on dead meat and maintain healthy surroundings. A dead organism spreads disease very quickly. So these scavengers, they eat the dead meat and maintain healthy habitat. Hyenas, eagle, they come under scavengers. Coming to the third group of animals, they are the omnivores. Omnivores are the animals that depend on plants as well as animals. They eat both the plant food and the animal food. Let us look at few examples. Pigs, crows, bears, chipmunks, chimpanzees, and we human beings are also omnivores. So, to look at the meaning of it, even this is from Latin, where omni gives us the meaning of all or everything. Omni means all or everything. Vor is to eat. So omnivores are all eaters. The animals that eat both plant food and animal food are called as omnivores. So these are the three main groups of animals based on their eating habits: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. All plant-eating animals are called herbivores. All flesh-eating animals are called carnivores. And animals that eat both plant food and animal food are called as omnivores. Do all the animals have same type of teeth? No. Animals have different types of teeth. Animals have different type of teeth according to the food they eat. Herbivores are the plant eaters, so they have the flat front teeth and wide back teeth. Most of the herbivorous animals are large in size, and to satisfy their hunger, most of the time they keep eating in a day. They eat large amount of food. So they cut the plants with the help of their front teeth and swallow the food without chewing. While they are relaxing, they get back the swallowed food from the stomach to the mouth and they start chewing and grinding with the help of their back teeth. This is called chewing the cud. In cows and buffaloes, you might have observed the process of chewing the cud. Coming to the carnivorous animals, as we know, they are the flesh eaters. They have the sharp pointed tearing teeth. Their cutting teeth are very short. They have the strong, sharp and pointed teeth as they need to tear the flesh of other animals. Carnivorous animals, they provide an important service to the wild by controlling the overpopulation of other animals. Coming to the omnivorous animals, as they are the all eaters, as they depend on plant and animal food, they have different types of teeth. They have the cutting teeth, tearing teeth, and also the grinding teeth. As they are the all eaters, they have different types of teeth. They have the flat front teeth and they have the tearing teeth and also the wide back teeth. So they have the advantage of getting variety of food. As they are the all eaters, they get their food throughout the year. During summers, usually they depend on fruits and nuts, whereas in the other seasons, they hunt the animals. We have learned the different eating habits of herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Let us observe few other different eating styles of few more animals. The first one is gnawing. What is meant by gnawing? Biting and chewing the food repeatedly by making it into small pieces is called gnawing. Examples: rat, rabbit, squirrel. You might have observed these animals eating their food. These are the animals where they use their front teeth, which are very sharp, eating their food by making them into very small pieces. So these type of animals are called gnawing animals. They have very sharp front teeth where they bite and make it into very small pieces before swallowing it. So this type of eating is called gnawing, and these animals are referred as gnawing animals. Rat, rabbit and squirrel are the few examples that come under gnawing animals. Next comes swallowing. You must be knowing the meaning of the word swallowing. Animals like snakes, lizards, and frogs they do not have teeth, they don't have teeth at all, then how are they going to consume their food? They swallow their food on a hole. If you have observed a frog will be throwing its sticky tongue in order to get its food. Even a lizard does the same. So these animals, they swallow their food. Even a python swallows its food. It can swallow as big as a deer. The crocodile, even it swallows a large chunk of the meat. It just tears the meat from its prey and it swallows without chewing it. So all these come under animals that swallow their food. Snakes, lizards, frogs, crocodiles, etc. And next, next comes lapping. What is meant by lapping? The licking movement of food is called as lapping. You might have observed the cats and dogs. They just lap the liquid with the help of their tongue. A dog will be lapping milk from its bowl. This type of licking movement of food is called as lapping. Dogs and cats, they are the lapping animals where they use their tongue to get their liquid food. Next comes sucking. Insects like butterflies and mosquitoes, they have a long tube. You know the food of a butterfly? It sucks nectar from the flowers. What is the food of a mosquito? A mosquito sucks blood from other animals. So, an insect like butterfly has a long tube in order to suck the nectar from the flowers. You know about the elephant. It uses its long trunk to gather the food and put it in its mouth. It has a very large, long trunk to gather the food and also to drink the water. An elephant has long trunk . These are the different eating styles observed in different animals. Gnawing, swallowing, lapping and sucking.